What's going on, guys? Welcome to another episode. This is episode number 10 of the Next Level series. I hope that everyone is all good. Today is Tuesday, 20th of April, and this is week number 2 since we've been back to the gym. As you guys can see, we are back in the gym, all right? The gym has been open back since the 12th of April, so last Monday. I hope that you guys enjoyed your return to the gym, and I hope that you guys, you know, I'm taking it easy the first few weeks before, you know, trying to lift some crazy amount of weight. Just take it step by step, especially if you haven't trained in a long time. Just take it easy and just enjoy the return, okay? Don't force no injuries, because if you get injured now, man, you'll be out for who knows how many weeks or how many months. So let's not take no risk. I definitely enjoyed my return last week, and one thing is for sure, I'm not as strong as I was before the lockdown, okay? Okay, so I got to humble myself and just do some baby steps. I believe it's going to take me at least two months before I feel that strength-wise, I'm back to 100%. A lot of exercises that I was able to smash a good amount of weight, and I did last week, and not that I was trying to lift the same weight, but I knew that strength wise I was not even close. I feel like right now I'm like 40%, where, you know, my strength right now is 40%. So that's why I think it's gonna take me at least 2 months, maybe just a little bit over than 2 months, to get my strength back, especially training in this type of gym that I'm training now, which is like a small gym inside the leisure center. As you guys know, Body Works is closed, and in Wellingborough, Body Works was the only pure, proper bodybuilding gym that you could go and train crazy, lift some good amount of weight, that have so many equipment. And now it's closed, so I'm back to a commercial gym. It's funny, because 3 years ago when I moved to Wellingborough, the first video that I did, you can go back on my channel and go back a few years, I did a video called No More Commercial Gym, because it's like I spent so many years training at gym like Banner Time, Fit for Less, Exercise for Less, Energy, Pure Gym. And then when I moved to Wellingborough and I joined Body Works Gym, I was like, yeah, no more. That's it. That's the type of gym that I need. But here we are now. We're back to a commercial gym, but I'm not complaining, because it's way better than me training outside where there's a chance of snow, rain, wind, and sun all in one session. I ain't got time for that. So, but yeah, it feels great to be back to the gym. It feels amazing. And like I said, it's a small gym. As you guys can see, it's a commercial gym. There's not a lot of equipment. And on top of that, some of the equipment are not available for use because of the distancing rule they do in the gym. So that sucks. So for example, last week on my leg day, there's a leg extension, which I did. And behind the leg extension machine, there's a seated leg curl. And I was going to use it, but you can't use it. There's a tape on it that prevents people to use it. So it's like you just have to be creative a little bit. But luckily, I know how to make the most out of a gym like this. You know, I've trained a similar gym years ago. It's just that I got really too comfortable to training in gym like Body Works. Even when I was training outside of Body Works, I would go to the Cave, for example, which is another proper bodybuilding gym. So, you know, I got too comfortable and in love with those type of gym that I was like, I'm never going to go back to a commercial gym again. But sometimes, you know, life is unpredictable and you just end up doing things that you told yourself you're not going to do. But it is what it is. We're still at the gym. So until I sort my driving out, because right now, you know, I don't drive, so I need to sort that out. Once I start driving, I'll have more options to go outside of Wellingborough and train. You know, there's a few good gyms just outside of Wellingborough, close to Northampton, and I could just go there and train. But for now, this will do. So, in terms, like I said, there's not a lot of equipment. Dumbbells-wise, only goes up to 30 kilos. So, on chest day, as you guys know, you've seen me benching 50-55 kg on chest press with dumbbells. So now I can't do that anymore, so I'm back to doing bench press. Like, I'm back to incline bench press, flat bench press, which is something that I haven't really focused on properly for at least the last 4 years. But I'm back on it. I'm back to I feel like I'm back to the beginning again, where when I started, everybody was just focused on how much do you bench. So I'm back to doing that. Just have to be careful to avoid injuries and just take it slowly and easy. You know, there's no rush. I gave myself 2 months, 2.5 months to fully recover strength-wise. And yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited to be back to the gym. I'm excited to see how I can take my physique to the next level. Now that I'm not competing, I don't have to worry about trying to get shredded or whatever. I can just, you know, eat properly, train, and make some lean gains, stay in shape all year round. And yeah, see where I can take my physique to. So I definitely do my best to try and travel to a different gym because I don't see myself training in that gym all the time. But yeah, I definitely try to do a little bit of traveling to go to a different gym because I need to do some exercises like dumbbell press. I need to keep a minimum of strength in that exercise in those exercises because I don't want to get to a point where I get stronger in certain exercise and things that I used to do before I get weaker. I don't want to do that. So every now and then I try my best to go to a different gym that have more equipment, more weight, you know, like rack pull, for example. I can't do no rack pull in this gym. The squat rack is not even available. You can't even use the squat rack. You guys are going to see at one point I'm doing barbell row. I'm doing it on the bench press. There's no squat rack. It's not available to use, you know what I'm saying? So exercises like rack pull, which was, you know, my bread and butter for the last 2-3 years, you know, I can't do that. And I need it for back thickness. So yeah, I definitely need to go to a different gym every now and then just to make sure that my body remembers how it feels to lift some proper heaviest weight on compound movement like rack pull, T-bar row, and stuff like that. But yeah, so today I went to the gym, I trained back. I thought, why not record? And it's been a long time. Just break, do a little break of videos. Like the last few videos were more business-wise for the End Fitness Clothing and just business in general. But like I said, the Next Level series is a combination of everything. So it's fitness, business, family, life, everything. Basically, I'm sharing with you guys my journey from now to the next 3 years, which is where I gave myself that ultimate goal in the next 3 years to be at a certain point that I need to be. So yeah, I thought why not do a workout video just to do a little break. So we trained back. I did some pull-ups to start. As you guys know, I always do pull-ups for my pre-warm-up. I did 4 pull-ups till failure each set. And then after that, I went to straight arm pull-down. And I did a few warm-up as well. And then I did every exercises that you guys are going to see me do were all 4 working set. And most of them, they all had a drop dead set at the last working set. So straight arm pull down, that was the first exercise, 4 working set. And I did a drop dead set at the end. And then I moved to front lat pull down, 4 working set. I did a drop dead set at the end. And then I did a reverse and grip lat pull down, 4 working set. And the drop down set at the end. And as you guys can see right now, I'm doing the close grip front lat pull down. So instead of sitting on the chair, I'm actually doing it with my knees on the floor. There's 2 reasons. The first reason is because I'm lower than being sitting on the chair, I have a wider range of motion. So on the way up, I feel like I can stretch a lot more and allow me to squeeze even more when I bring the weight. When I bring the grip my way, if you know what I mean. So that was the first reason. The second reason is because you're on the floor, the swinging and you don't use your legs the form is way more stricter. So basically, it allows you to focus more on the lats. And that's the 2 reasons why I'd like to do this sometimes on the floor. Just a better, more focused form and a wider range of motion for stretch and squeeze. And then after that, move to barbell row. As you guys can see, that's what I was saying, there's no squat rack. So basically, luckily, the bench was available. And that's another thing as well in this gym. I cannot plan my sessions Like, I can only plan the muscle group that I want to train, but I cannot plan the exercises ahead. Like a bodyweight gym, I would write the night before the workout, I will write everything down. So this way I could visualize the workout, but I can't do that right now because it's a small gym. So I don't want to write something down and I get to the gym and everything is taken, you know, or the equipment I want to use is taken. So I just go based on what's available. Even the order of the exercises that I did today was just based on what was available. So I just jump from one equipment to another. And as I was saying, my strength wise, I feel like I'm like 40%. As you guys can see, I'm doing a barbell row with 100 kg. And if you guys know me by now, you know I was doing with 120, 130, 140. I think once me and Jan, we pushed it to 150, which was quite hard, but it felt amazing. But there's no way I'll put in more than two plates right now. Like those two plates, I was feeling it. But I did two plates last week. I did two plates today. And I believe next week I'll be able to try like 110. Like I'm going to take my time until I get to where I need to be. So there's no rushing. And then the next exercise, which is the last exercise of the workout. This is something that I love. This is like an alternative for me from the strength machine that we had at Bodyworks Gym for the lat and pull down strength machine row. We don't have that, so I love to use this. So I use the incline bench for support and then just try to bring the weight and try to bring the cable down for a nice squeeze on the lats. So yeah, that was the workout for today. Did six exercises. And I'm going to do back again when I do arms. I'm training arms on Thursday, so I'm going to do arms and then back, just a little bit of back, like a little touch up. And this is it. That's the workout. So that's the first workout video. That's the first gym workout video of the year. Hopefully the gym won't be closing again because I am tired of this bullshit. I'm sure a lot of people are. But let's stay positive. I'm sure they're not going to close. Fingers crossed they don't close. But yeah, that was today's bike workout. Cardio-wise, I'm going to show you guys what I'm currently eating because I got two photo shoots coming up. I got one photo shoot for my AN Fitness launch and I got another one on the 21st of July. So I need to get photo shoot ready. And luckily, because I'm lean already, as you guys are going to see, I'm going to show you a quick physique update. So I'm lean already, so I don't need to do a lot of changes. I'm just small adjustment on my diet, which I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to do a video full day of eating just to show you guys what I'm currently eating right now. And cardio, I do cardio. I do 20 minutes on the bike, 20 minutes. Or I go out for a 3K run with Nala. And Sunday morning, I usually go and do a 5K run with Jan. So I do cardio every day. So I try to do at least 3 runs of 3K and just benefit for myself, but also for Nala. You know, give her some exercise and to do. And then I do the rest. I do one run of 5K with Jan on Sundays, and then the rest I do bike. So cardio every day, 20 minutes bike. The 3K run, when I run on my own, I can do that in quite a good amount of time. But when I run with Nala, it takes me like 16, 17 minutes because sometimes she stops sniffing everywhere. But it's still a good, I have a very good sweat at the end of the run, so that's perfect. And then on the bike, I do 20 minutes. And then usually when I do my 5K run, it's anything around 25 minutes, 26 minutes. On a good day, maybe just under 25 minutes. But yeah, this is what's going on. So that's the physique update right now. And which is not too bad, you know, especially knowing that how the lockdown was. But yeah, I'm gonna do more workout videos. I'm very excited to be back to the gym. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. And feel free to subscribe, like, share. Until the next video, catch you in a bit.